found yourself in a difficult situation of being at the end of the disease and very sick. The alternative is to continue to get sicker or to source your own treatment. And certainly we've been interested in 100 New Zealand to access the generic versions of these treatments.
After years of campaigning, Maverick is now going to be funded from February. And you hear so she and others have prepared a timing of celebration to mark the occasion.
We are over the moon. That's why we're pulling out the stops and all going to meet and all things to really notice it. But we can't make such a big victory pass without celebrating and without calling attention to it, because it's going to make such a difference to so many people's lives. 250 deaths estimated per year in New Zealand still with Hep C, and those are all avoidable things.
But Hazel Hill says their work is not over yet. There is one barrier as they aim to make New Zealand C3 by 2025.
Stigma is a killer. Stigma causes people not to discuss it in the workplace, and stigma causes people not to discuss options and just to post them in. We are really the modern letters people should see. People shrink back, and even if they don't know anything about it, they kind of got this idea that there's something to see, and that's what we've got to do away with.
And with thousands of New Zealanders still not even aware they have the virus, her advice is to get checked. It may save a life, and thanks to the work of her and others, treatment is more accessible than ever before.
It's Barney Dreamer reporting. And a set of Chinese squirrels has posted a video in a bid to have tea with Britain's Queen Elizabeth, and it's all because of the popular cell phone. So, keep up the pace. BBC China correspondent John Fogworth takes the story.
And a huge global trend.
Walk around
the muddy puddle. This episode, in which Catherine meets the Queen,
looks down,
made a splash a long way from Britain. After watching it, these tiny things posted this message to the Queen, asking if they could also visit her too. The video's been viewed almost 4 million times. And it worked. Thought of.
Hello, Mimi and me. I'm the British ambassador, so I'm the British Queen's representative in China. I'd like you to come and visit me in my house in Beijing, and we can perhaps have tea and scones in a British style, and we can talk about making your dream come true.
It's not quite the same as tea with the Queen, perhaps. But the twins were also given the promise of a trip to the UK.
But all of it is a sign that Britain sees a little pig-shaped icon as a huge opportunity, and that for the British government to promote industries like tourism, the hope is that Pepper can bring home the bacon.
Pepper Pig is a huge British success story in China, with 18 billion, yes, billion, yellows and blues. She even has her subverted side with Pepper tattoos now used as a symbol of an underground chanter culture.
We've seen the success of Premier League football here, we've seen Paddington Vale, we've seen Downton Abbey, we've seen Sherlock, and Pepper Pig is another manifestation of how UK culture around the world, and that's great for creativity, it's great for the UK, and it's great for tourism as well.
With the Queen preparing to jet off to Britain, diplomats must be wishing all UK-China diplomacy today.